I remember I wasn't much older than four, maybe five at the most. To go to school mornings were colder, no such thing as a bus. Our mother was searching for school bags and combing our hair the wrong way. As she buttered our toast and buttoned our coats, here's what my mother would say. We all need a hug in the morning and one at the end of the day. As many as possible squeezed in between to keep life's troubles at bay. No matter wherever you ramble, your problems be great or be small, it is my belief, for instant relief, a hug is the best cure of all.
I met an old exile in Boston who longed to go back home one day, but he thought no one there would be caring, for he'd been so long away. To stop a teardrop in his coffee, he gave his old whiskers a tug, and I knew that he'd give all he needed to live for a big welcome home again, home.
We all need a hug in the morning and one at the end of the day. As many as possible squeezed in between to keep life's troubles at bay. No matter wherever you ramble, your problems be great or be small, it is my belief, for instant relief, a hug is the best cure of all. A letter can bring consolation, a phone call can brighten the night. In the midst of great aggravation, they can put at least some things to right. But when your heart feels like it's breaking, your life slipping down past the plug, and you feel like a ghost, the thing you want most is someone to give you a hug. And we all need a hug in the morning and one at the end of the day. As many as possible squeezed in between to keep life's troubles at bay. No matter wherever you ramble, your problems be great or be small, it is my belief, for instant relief, a hug is the best cure of all.